Hello friends, welcome to IELTS Master Class. Today I would like to begin the study strategy for the IELTS speaking test. Well, basically it is our first lesson, so I would like to request all the listeners, let's start. Study strategies for the IELTS speaking test. In this section, we'll look at the study strategies for general speaking practice, speaking practice for the IELTS test, specific practice for each part of speaking test. For the test, we should do some general speaking practice, IELTS speaking test. Well, to do this, you should develop a study program so that you can practice speaking at the last an hour every day. Let's see the studies in general speaking test. In general speaking, will help you build your confidence, extend your vocabulary, and develop your pronunciation and fluency by using a wide range of topics and everyday context. Well, speaking activity with other people, you have to practice in every day. It is difficult to practice speaking alone, we know. Therefore, you should make every effort possible to find someone to speak with. I think it would be better for us to develop ourselves during class. Well, if you are a student, it will be easy for you study English at a school, university or college. You should make an effort to speak in English to your teachers and the other student as much as possible, because you can do this by actively practicing in class to answer the teacher's question. Let's conversation groups. If you miss your speaking proficiency, you should develop a conversation groups. Many towns and cities have English language conversation groups or clubs. Next, everyday situation. Find cities in which to practice your. If you are in English speaking country, in this very easy to do. You can practice speaking with local people in practice, such as supermarket and shops, restaurants, on the bus, the taxi driver, etc. If you do not live in English speaking country, then what can't you do? You can still find way of speaking in English with other people. For example, you may have English speaking exchange student at your school whom you can talk to. Alternatively, you may be able to find an Australian, England or Canada, English or American or Irish people where you are likely to meet other people speaking English as part of their second language. You can choose the alternative way, speaking activities on your own. If you are unable to find someone to practice speaking English with, then what can you do? Try to follow some activity on your own. Definitely, television and radio programs in English will be very useful for you. Less thinking, my friends. Record program in English on cassette. For example, you could record a short news items, whether a report from the television or radio. Listen to cassette a few times and transcript. Do you notice the transcript? Definitely, you know. Transcript is a written papers of conversation. By the doing this, you can practice listening for a fluency and coherence, vocabulary, grammar and pronunciation. Then practice speaking in text yourself. Secondly, use audiovisual resources. Go to library, my friends, or bookshops and borrow or buy English language textbooks with cassettes and CDs. Audiovisual resources can provide you with good English speaking modules and are often structured to help you develop different areas of speaking. Example, pronunciation, fluency, coherence, grammar. Well, while you are outside It will be outstanding strategy. Even if you are not in English speaking country, you may see English words while you are outside, especially large town and cities. Look at the shop names, street names, advertisement, and notice on the buses and trains. You can also look at the number plates on cars, telephone numbers, and on the street. Practice reading the English words you see and saying the number of in English to yourself. Thirdly, song and videos. Listen to song and definitely it would be English that you like. Learn the words. You can transcribe them or even find them on the internet too, and repeat them to yourself as you repeat. I would like to request, please, if you don't understood something, you can repeat in this topics in YouTube also. That will be great for you. Well, then try to sing with the music and practice this until you know the song without looking at the words. Please watch a movie in English and try to learn some of the words and phrases the actors use. You know, this will help you hear about the context of, and build your range of vocabulary. Well, internet site script of Flame in English. Often people in Australia, America, Canada, English movies by reading the script and listening to and or watching the movie. You know, you can learn new words and phrases. Develop your skill in English by practice these new words and phrases. Last but not the least, thinking in English, you know, it's very innovative idea, my dear friends. Thinking in English in your daily life, you know, whatever you think, not in your native language, it should be, it must be thinking in English. You can do this everywhere and every time. Nevertheless, you are always thinking, but usually in your native language. Have a period of time every day, such as when you are on the bus or laying the bed, when you thinking only in the English. For example, imagination, conversation with a friend. Imagine what you would like to about and how you would express yourself in English. Try to, my dear friend, try, because there haven't any alternative way without practice. And we are all well known, practice and practice makes a man perfect. You can describe your house, your room, your daily routine. Well, now we would like to look the study strategy as speaking practice. Well, specific speaking practice for the IELTS test will help become familiar with the format of IELTS test and prepare to the specific type of questions you will be asked during that test. Below are some suggestions for ways in which you can develop your specific speaking skill for the IELTS test. Well, firstly, start your own speaking skills group. Well, find other students who are not doing to test. You can exchange ideas or answering questions and receive feedback on your speaking skill from your other students in these groups. So mind it, start your own speaking skill groups. It would be first idea for improve your speaking skill. Secondly, role play on IELTS interview. It could be mock test. Alternatively, decide, practice speaking different dialogue with yourself. Question the examiner might ask you and how would you answer those questions. Listen to sample transcript on the interview speaking. Analyzes the candidate's speaking ability. What did the candidate do well? What could they improve? Keep your vocabulary book. While you study, develop a list of vocabulary related to each of the topics areas IELTS speaking test. You sum up this vocabulary every time you practice your speech. Nowadays, we are always using internet by Facebooking, by YouTube, and so a lot, thousands of materials in the website, you know. So using the internet, understanding platform for everyone. Okay, there are many websites in the internet that offer suggestions and activities to help you improve both your general speaking ability and speaking for the IELTS test. Well, use a good search engine and experiment with the keywords such as IELTS speaking preparation, English pronunciation, or speaking activity. Well, some internet sites allow you to listen the news and also provide transcripts in English. By listening to up-to-date information on current issues and develop your vocabulary, ideas related to IELTS topics, speaking skills by listening to models of English language. Useful site for this include. So you may browse the abc.net. ABC means Australian Broadcasting Corporation. It's a English TV channel, and BBC, you know, all of us, CNN also. Let's begin strategy tips. Okay, now look at the following tips to help you with the specific strategy for the IELTS part 1, 2 and 3. Well, first, don't be afraid to speak. Even if you make mistakes, you cannot learn without making mistakes. When you practice answering questions by brainstorming useful vocabulary and ideas before you start, by doing this, you build your vocabulary and expand your ideas as well as develop your speaking. Well, when you practice answering question to IELTS speaking test, ask a friend to listen, give you suggestions to improve your speaking. On the other hand, as record your speaking and evaluate your speaking skill using the speaking test criteria for fluency and coherence, vocabulary, grammar and pronunciation. Now we would like to go your attention for specific study strategy for part 1. Remember, my friends, that part 1 of the speaking test covers topics such as your home, country, family, friends, tips, work, studies, interest, hobbies, and daily routine. You should try to develop a range of vocabulary in these topics area so that you are able to speak about them easily. And below are some suggestions. Imagine you are meeting someone for the first time. What the question would you ask to find you more about them and the country they would from? For example, what do you like doing in your spare time? It would be one. And also, it could be, what are some places tourists like to visit in your country? Next, develop your own list of possible questions for part 1. My dear friend, write each question on a different of pieces of paper. Keep these questions with you during the day, and when you have a few minutes to spare, take out a question and practice how you would answer it about yourself. Okay, fine. Let's specific study strategy for part 2. In part 2 of speaking test, required to give a short talk or presentation, 1 or 2 minutes, definitely on the topics that is familiar to you. So a good strategy is to practice talking on a range of topics. Remember to time yourself and, if possible, record your talk. Give a short talk presentation. Practice talking for 1 to 2 minutes on the following topics. Describe a person who has been important in your life. Talk about a film you have seen recently. Describe a festival in your country. Describe your ideal job. talk about hobby you had when you were young, and last talk about a member of your family that you have a good relationship with. Specific study strategy for part 3 on IELTS speaking test. In part 3 of the IELTS speaking test, focus on developing and expanding on idea. The topic in thematically linked to part 2. For example, if you asked about your home country in part 2, definitely in a conversation in home in part 3. And questions are often abstract or the general interest rather than related to your personal background. You may be required to discuss past and present situation and imagine in future. So in this part, develop your own questions. Look at the example of part 2, questions that you have find thought out of the speaking module. Mainly in this step 2 and in the practice test, identify the main topics in each questions and then develop your own part of 3 question using each of the topics. For example, part 2 question, describe your ideal holiday. Topics, ideal holiday. Example, part 3 question, the topics in part 2 is ideal holiday. So a more general topics that is related to the travel and tourism. Here are some possible questions. Explain how international travel could foster positive relationships between countries. Number 2, describe some of the disadvantages of tourism. Number 3, suggest way in which of the government could increase tourism in your country. As you think of general topics and related questions, write them on a separate piece of paper. Keep this question with you during a day and when you have a few times to spare. Take out a question and practice how you would answer it. There is also a list of possible questions or partly in step 2 speaking module. Okay, below are some questions to help you develop your range of vocabulary, ideas and speaking skill for part 3. Well, use newspaper and magazine would be great help improving your skills. To answer question more effectively, you need to develop your ideas and build your vocabulary by reading English language newspaper and magazine. It is difficult or expensive to get English language newspaper in your country. Most of them can now be found on internet by using this site. Well, newspaper and magazine are usually divided into the following section. News stories keep you up to date with the latest stories and current issues. Theme related information, articles with different themes, for example technology, health and future phases, have longer articles on topics of general interest and often discuss topics with various viewpoints, the opinion or editorial phase. Contain the opinion of newspaper, they are often presented as a strong argument in favor of against a particular topics. Now later to the editor, often comments on the article from the previous day of the newspaper or previous month of a magazine, and you can be another good source of ideas the particular topics. Generally speaking, my dear friends, we have finished today's session. Now let's look the summary. In this session, we have learned study strategy for general speaking practice, number 2 speaking practice of the IELTS test, and thirdly specific practice for each part of speaking test. Make sure that in the weeks before the speaking test, you would try to speak as often as you can. Thank you very much for watching.